ready to match the star. Don Adams. Red Summer. Charles Nelson Reilly. Mitzi McCall. Richard Dawson. And Elaine Joyce. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Roberts.
Johnny Olson, and thank you for joining us here on Match Game 74. How are all of the bodies today?
Fantastic.
I have an announcement to make.
Brett has an announcement to make.
I'm leaving.
I'm wearing two pairs of eyelashes on the tops of my eyes. I look just like Betty Boop.
Yes.
And her wig is false also.
That's true.
And
three crunch
hair. No. That's as far as we'll go.
And
well, No. That's enough. Cut.
How do you think up all those terrific positions?
You mean the crazy entrances?
Yeah.
Did you see it the day I rolled down the stairs?
Did I ever?
Yeah. I was going to do it again for you. I'm sorry you said yes, but I'm not rolling down the stairs today. I'm going to say hello to these two bodies over here. Timothy O'Keefe and Sandy Corey. Hello, bodies.
Hello, Gene.
How are you?
Fine.
Tim is a current champ. He's won one game, and he has $200 to his credit. Well, that's better than a fill in the blank there. Hey, there's a question for you. Winning $200 is better than blank. And we're going to start a brand new game right now. And to do that, we have to introduce a new body. And have we got some body for you in the person of Sandy Corey here.
Sandy, you can tell us about yourself.
Okay. I'm originally from Erie, Pennsylvania. I now live in Los Angeles, and I sell real estate in Beverly Hills.
No kidding.
Yes, no, I love it.
They call you Sandy because you have sandy-colored hair.
I didn't have it last week.
Oh.
Oh, that's
all
funny.
Right. Have you met Brett? Okay, we'll begin this game in a moment or so, but first we've got a little something for you, and this is it. Here we go. I'll push this button and reveal two questions here in round one and ask our challenger to make a selection.
B.
B is what you want, and B is what you get. Everybody plays brand new game. The big bad wolf said to Little Red Riding Hood, "Quit bugging me, kid. I didn't eat your grandmother. That's my own blank hanging out of my mouth." That's it. Little Red Riding Hood. See, the big bad wolf said to her, "Quit bugging me, kid. I didn't eat your grandmother. That's my own blank hanging out of my mouth."
Okay. Well, now you've given it a different reading.
Or my own blank hanging out of my mouth. That's my own blank hanging out of my mouth. How do you want it? I'll read it any way you want. First, and Elaine's the best there.
No, not the best.
Now, just take a peek at that.
Yes. Is it dumb?
That's okay. All right, Brett's ready.
Coughing. I have one sick
coughing
over here, one coughing over there. If I get through this, it'll be a bloody miracle. And they're both asleep between answers.
Hey, Charles, okay.
Come party.
Now, we'll call on Sandy. Big Bad Wolf said to Little Red Riding Hood, "Quit bugging me, kid. I didn't eat your grandmother. That's my own blank hanging out of my mouth."
Dress.
Dress. That tickles my fancy. Because I didn't know the Big Bad Wolf wore a dress.
Silly.
John?
Nope.
Nope?
Nope.
What did you say?
Tongue.
Tongue. That's my own color. That's a good answer. Yeah. Brett?
I thought I had a real winner here.
You did.
I said, "That's my own grandmother hanging out of
well,
my
that's
mouth."
A good answer, too. That's very good, Charles.
If you hate your family, it's a terrific answer.
Why not?
It's that bonnet. I'm sorry.
Bonnet.
Sandy.
All right. An article of clothing is what Sandy had in mind, but not that. She said dress. What do you say?
Well, I'm working on the same wavelength as Mr. Adams. I said tongue.
Tongue. Okay. And Richard, what wavelength are you on?
I don't know, but that proves we have a loser here and up there as
yes
well.
Yes, he's not coming back on the show.
He did wear a dress, the wolf. Don't you remember he got into a dress?
Right. It was one of his disguises. Yes.
I also have a dress at home.
You do?
And I'm shook about it.
Okay. Elaine, what?
Well, I happen to know that this wolf was always saying the wrong things. So he had his own foot hanging out of his mouth.
Foot in his mouth. All right. So that's one for you, and now let's see how Timothy O'Keefe does. Here we go, Tim. Everybody assembled on this day must remember Don Adams' marvelous TV show called Get Smart. You all remember that, right?
Yeah.
Yay!
Yeah.
At one point, in one of those great episodes, Secret Agent Maxwell Smart said, "Chief, I refuse to wear that King Kong gorilla disguise. Every time I put it on, I have an insane desire to blank."
I don't remember the show.
You don't remember the show when you said that? I remember it very well. Says, "Chief, I refuse to wear that King Kong gorilla disguise. Every time I put it on, I have an insane desire to blank."
I don't remember that particular show.
Oh, I remember it well. It was episode 1257. Because remember, you did that show.
They were mirth-provoking shows.
They were marvelous shows.
Must have been the first year.
Did you come up with an answer?
Yes, I got to put it in.
Would you put it in
a slot, please? Okay.
I've tried to help him. He refuses to be helped.
Now, where are we here? We're up to Timothy. Chief, I refuse to wear that King Kong gorilla disguise. Every time I put it on, I have an insane desire to...
climb the Empire State Building.
Climb the Empire State Building. How's Jinglings? Think you got a winning answer down there. What do you say?
Now I remember that show.
What'd you like to tell us about it?
But I was never good at dialogue, so I put swing from the chandelier.
Swing from the chandelier. What'd you put? All right, Smart. Get out of the room. Get out of town, Smart. What do you say, Brett?
Oh.
Do you mind?
Don't cough, Florette.
Good gravy, Marie.
Would you like to show and tell?
I'm such a romantic, you know.
Yes, you are.
I said, kiss Faye Ray.
Kiss Faye Ray. Yeah, that's very appropriate.
I'm sorry, I thought of that, Timothy.
Too late.
And then I said, because I'm so ill, I said, fine, Faye Ray.
Fine, Faye Ray. He said, climb the Empire State Building. What do you say?
99? I said, monkey around.
Monkey around. Hey, the secret word, and you get $100.
That's the most ridiculous thing I ever heard.
That's right. What do you
say? I said the secret word and said, meet Fay Ray.
Meet Fay Ray. Right. Fay Ray seems to figure in many of the answers here, Tim. What do you say, Elaine?
And after he had this desire to meet and kiss and talk to Fay Ray, he wanted to attack Fay Ray.
Oh, really? Okay. So, at the end of round one, we've got 1-0 in favor of our challenger, Sandy. And round two is coming up in a little bit, but first, this is coming your way. All right, here we go. Shall we push the button here and reveal our second round questions and ask Sandy, our challenger, to make a selection?
I think I'll take B.
You'll take B. Okay.
Okay.
B is what she wants. B is what she gets. Sarah said, the only way I can forget my old boyfriend, the doctor, is to have a blank once a day. Sarah said that.
She did.
Yep. The only way I can forget my old boyfriend, the doctor, is to have a blank once a day. You don't.
Yuckies. I don't understand.
Well, just study it for a second there. Put your glasses on and read it.
Gravy. Sarah said the only way I can forget my old boyfriend, the doctor, is to have a blank once a day. Would you like your question back?
Yes, and would you like to write something on the card?
Oh, all right.
And
okay,
put it in the slot, because that's the way the whole thing operates.
Gotta put me next to her.
Yeah. You're just lucky, Don. Okay, I guess we're all set. Everyone but Richard participated because Sandy matched Richard the first round. And now, we call on you, Sandy. Sarah said the only way I can forget my old boyfriend, the doctor, is to have a blank once a day.
Apple.
Yeah! An apple a day keeps a doctor away.
That's right. I was thinking it was for a teacher.
Oh, boy, oh, boy. Apple is her answer. She came up with a...
that would remind her of the doctor.
No,
the only way that you can forget your doctor is to have... Oh.
It's in the little slot.
Is to have a blackout once a day.
Oh, terrific.
Then you forget everything.
Then you forget everything then.
Next.
Yeah, next, Brett.
I was very embarrassed by my answer until I heard his. I said to have a examination.
A examination once a day. That's the only way to forget their boyfriend, the doctor. Charles?
I'm sorry, but I don't understand American answers. Is the object of the game? I much match the girl.
That's the object.
Like
yes.
Apple.
Apple.
Like
that. Are you going to help this girl or not?
Oh, gosh. I like cold apples. Does it count to say cold? I'm
Have
sorry.
A cold one today.
I'm sorry, Sam.
Okay. And Elaine, we come to you, my dear.
Well, I was thinking more of the doctor. And, you know, no matter what you have, a backache, the plague, it doesn't make any difference. They always say, take an aspirin.
Okay. So have an aspirin once a day. Now, Tim, we come to you.
I'll take A.
Okay, fourth graders told him to say that. Two to tie, three to win. Jessica lost her blank while skiing down the Swiss Alps. Jessica lost her blank while skiing down the Swiss Alps.
It's a wonderful image.
Oh, it's a terrific question. Think about that, Timothy O'Keefe. Jessica lost her blank while skiing down the Swiss Alps.
Don Adams is the first one finished.
Always.
Don Adams is really smart.
Oh, very smart. Charles.
You know, think about Charles doesn't even begin to write until it all gets transferred.
He thinks a lot.
I think he's smoking funny cigarettes. He's wearing dark glasses.
Those are new glasses, aren't they?
No, he lost his other ones.
All right.
Only at least the
How come dog? He's dressing so snappy all of a sudden? Okay, here
old.
We go. Timothy O'Keefe. Jessica lost her blank while skiing down the Swiss Alps.
Should I give a funny answer?
Well, Timothy, hold everything now. It's entirely up to
Think
you, but I must point
it.
Out to you the object is to win the money or win the game or whatever. So, but, you know, it's you do whatever you think will match the celebrities. Or if you just want to blow the whole thing and do jokes, well, that's okay with us, too. Jessica lost her blank while skiing down the Swiss Alps. Two to tie, three to win. We got all day,
Gosh,
Tim.
She lost her skis.
She lost her skis.
That wasn't the funny answer.
No, that was not the funny answer, quite obviously. Afterwards, you can tell us a funny answer.
Did you hear that laugh?
Skis. She lost her skis while... Go ahead, Don.
Jessica lost her pole.
Lost her pole. All right. There's a logical answer. You can drop a pole while skiing. Brett?
Do you remember that girl on the subway and what she lost?
Yes.
Jessica lost the same thing. Her innocence.
Her innocence. Coming down the mountain. Charles?
Virginity.
Virginity.
I'm gonna say that. You should have said it.
All right.
That was a funny answer.
Was that your funny answer?
You should have said it's not a funny answer. Everyone was going to put panties, but you can't lose your panties if you have skis on. Think
That's
about
true.
It.
I've never lost mine, I'll tell you that. Mitzi, how about you? What
well,
does Jessica
I figure
lose?
You lose, you know, your innocence at the ski lodge afterwards. I sort of said the same thing Don Adams said. Not sort, I did say.
Yeah,
she
the
lost
ski
her
poles.
Poles.
Now
Sorry.
You've got to match both Richard and Elaine to stay in the game. Oh. Richard.
Well, I have good news and bad news for you, Timothy.
Will everybody stop doing me?
Why?
I bought you the house. Bought you the house in Beverly Hills.
No, she lost her balance.
Lost her balance.
Coming down.
So that means Sandy wins the game. What was yours, Elaine? While we say farewell to Timothy O'Keefe. Sorry to see you go, Tim Old Bean.
Hi, Grandma.
Goodbye, Grandma. But so long, Tim. A gift for you backstage and $200 in cash. Now, Sandy, we got the Big Money Super Match coming up for you. But before we get to that, we've got to get to this and do a little business, and then we'll come right back. Yes, indeed. All right, here we are with Sandy Corey. Are you ready, Sandy? Okay, you're going to have a go at the Big Money Super Match here, over $5,000. And here's how it goes. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. T blank.
Oh.
T hyphen blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match that. If you match the next one, it's $250. If you match the third, it's $100 for you. Which celebrities would you like to get a little assist from here?
Don.
Don.
Oh. We don't put it in there.
Smart girl. Okay.
T-blank.
T-shirt.
T-shirt. Okay. And Mitzi.
T-P.
T-P.
No.
That's your answer.
Oh, gosh.
You're stuck
with... Can I be an Indian giver?
No. T-P is her answer. And one more.
Ann Richard.
Ann Richard.
T-Bone.
Oh, T-Bone. So you've got a T-Bone, T-P, and a T-shirt. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. Sandy, what would you like to do?
I think I'll pick T-Bone.
T-Bone. Okay. She wants the steak. You want it medium, well done, or rare? How do you like her?
Medium rare.
Medium rare.
And prime rib.
And prime rib. Nothing is too good for you, Sandy.
Oh,
come with me,
potatoes?
And to heck with it. No. T-Bone is what she's after. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response? T-Bone steak right off the bat. Thought it was going to be up there a little bit higher than that.
Yeah,
yeah. Did you think that too?
I
don't know. Audience, what do you think is under $250?
T-shirt.
T-bird. T-P. All right, here's $250.
T-bird.
T-bird. You're right.
T-shirt, $20.
T-shirt.
T-shirt. All right. Disrobe and show us. T-shirt is right.
Get a lesson.
Yeah.
Okay, T-P was good, Mitzi.
Thank you,
T-bone
Brad,
steak.
My friend.
There is $100 for you, and now you play for 10 times that amount, or $1,000. But to collect it, you've got to match one celebrity. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Okay, Richard. Now, this will have to be an exact match. You face me, if you please, Sandy. All right, here it is. Blank vault. V-A-U-L-T. Blank vault. Blank vault. I'll give you both accents. You both make up your minds. He's finished. Now, Sandy, how do you respond to this in order to match Richard? Blank vault.
Bank vault.
Bank vault. Audience thinks you've got a rigor. Well, we all hope so. Don't we all hope so?
We all hope so.
Richard, for $1,000. It's show and tell time.
What did Sandy say?
Bank vault is what she said.
But, you know, we do gymnast.
Oh. Are you a gymnast?
You know, leaping over.
Vaulting, yeah.
Pole vault, very good. I wrote bank vault.
Yeah.
At the last minute, he writes a bank vault on his card over there and gets a kiss out of Sandy. Well, Sandy, you're up to $1,200. We congratulate you, and you're going to meet another challenger right now. You ready for that?
Oh, yes.
Okay, let's welcome Diane Jackson.
Hello,
Diane.
Hello. How are you?
Fine, thank you. You know, Sandy? Okay, would you tell us about the Diane Jackson story, if you please?
Well, I'm a teacher. I'm married to a preacher. I have two daughters, and I teach at Centennial High School in Compton, California.
Well, it's nice to have you with us. Okay, I'll push a button here and ask our challenger to make a selection.
B, please.
B is what she wants. Everybody plays new game. The admiral said to the sailor, I don't mind a man taking a little souvenir from the Navy, but you should be court-martialed for taking home a blank. All right. Admiral said to the sailor, did you hear that, Diane?
Yes.
I don't mind a man taking a little souvenir from the Navy, but you should be court-martialed for taking home a blank. Everybody ready? Simple, isn't it?
Yes,
I don't know why they're waiting.
Well,
mind your own business.
Right, the right thing up.
Okay, Navy.
Why is Dickie Dawson always picking on me?
He's picking on you.
Speed up.
Because
speed
he
up.
Loves you. All right, Diane. The admiral said to the sailor, I don't mind a little man taking a little souvenir from the Navy, but it should be court-martialed for taking home a...
ship.
A ship.
Took the whole ship home. That's quite a souvenir. Don, what do you say?
That was a little greedy. I just said an anchor.
An anchor. All right. And Brett.
Well, I started to say sailor, and he made me so nervous that I said ship.
Oh. Well, that's one for you. And Charles.
I don't want to preach her mad at me. Ship.
A ship, there it is. That's two. Diane, what do you say?
The little dummy finally is shaping up. Ship.
Ship. So, ship shape. What do you say, Richard Dawson?
Dearly beloved, shape up or
ship up. All right. And Elaine.
Oh, ship.
Oh, there it is. You did very well with that, all but one. So, we'll come to your question a little bit later. Right now, we've got to do a little business, America. Here it is. Thank you, one and all. You were just beautiful.
Thank you.
Join us next time. Gene Rayburn, Match Game 74. Goodbye.
Stay tuned for Title Tales, next over most of the CBS stations.